Which molecule is the master blueprint, and which is the messenger running errands for the cell? If you said DNA holds the instructions and RNA delivers them, you nailed it. But the real story goes deeper. In this video, you'll learn the major differences between DNA and RNA. Explore the three main types of RNA and see how they all work together to make life happen. DNA, or deoxyribonucleic acid, is shaped like a double helix, two strands twisted together. In eukaryotic cells, it stays in the nucleus, storing the complete genetic code. In prokaryotes, it floats freely in the cytoplasm. Meanwhile, RNA, or ribonucleic acid, is single-stranded. In eukaryotic cells, it can leave the nucleus and deliver genetic instructions to other parts of the cell, while in prokaryotes, it works directly in the cytoplasm. One big chemical difference: DNA has deoxyribose sugar, while RNA uses ribose, which has one extra oxygen atom. That tiny change makes a big difference. Another difference lies in the bases they use. DNA pairs A with T and G with C. RNA, on the other hand, pairs A with U instead of T, while still pairing G with C. This switch makes RNA distinct from DNA during transcription and protein synthesis. Because of these chemical and base pairing differences, their stability also differs. DNA is stable and stays in the nucleus. RNA, however, is more temporary. It's transcribed, used, and then broken down quickly in the cytoplasm. Think of DNA as the master blueprint and RNA as the messenger carrying instructions to build proteins. So far, we've compared their structure, bases, and stability. That's a lot to take in, so it's the perfect place to pause and practice. Curious how much you're remembering? Your personalized practice test, flashcard set, and study guide are all waiting for you. Just tap the link now and keep watching. Future you will thank you. With those basics fresh, let's look closer at RNA's specialized forms. mRNA, or messenger RNA, carries instructions from DNA to ribosomes, the places where proteins are made. The mRNA is read by the ribosome, which uses it like a recipe to build a protein, one amino acid at a time. tRNA, or transfer RNA, acts like a delivery worker. It brings the right amino acids to the ribosome based on the mRNA's code. Each tRNA has an anticodon that pairs with a codon on the mRNA, ensuring the correct amino acid is added to the growing protein chain. Finally, rRNA, or ribosomal RNA, makes up the structure of the ribosome. It helps bind the mRNA and tRNA, and even catalyzes the formation of peptide bonds between amino acids, making protein synthesis possible. Now that we've seen the three main types, let's step back to the bigger picture. RNA isn't just a helper. It's central to making proteins, regulating genes, and even serving as a genetic material in some viruses like the flu and COVID-19. So, to recap, DNA is double-stranded, stable, and stores the genetic blueprint in the nucleus. RNA is single-stranded, temporary, and works in the nucleus and cytoplasm to turn that blueprint into proteins. Together, DNA stores the plan and RNA carries it out. That's teamwork at the molecular level. Ready to quiz yourself with the content covered in this video? Check out the link in the description where you'll find Quizlet content made just for you.